Hi there, I'm Kathleen Jasper. Today I'm going to be showing you how to locate free reading passages online that you can use to help you study for your reading assessment. So some of you are studying for your teacher certification exam, either the Praxis Core or another exam for reading, or maybe you are a high school student trying to get better at your ACT or SAT reading. Well, a really good way to do that is to read a passage a day, and in order to do that, you need to find extra passages. So today I'm going to show you how to do that. Let's get started. All right, so most of the people that we work with are studying for their teacher certification exam, and a lot of them have a hard time with the timed reading assessment on the Praxis Core. We have, you know, two full practice tests. I think there's something like 40 or 60 reading passages in there. However, you might be someone who needs more practice because you want to read a passage every night. So I'm going to show you how to locate those online for free so you have something to practice and work through that reading. Now, if you're struggling with any reading exam, I always recommend that you read incrementally every night. It's called incremental practice. The reason being is that reading is a skill that needs to be nurtured, needs to be strengthened. So it's a little bit different than a content test. For example, if you were studying for the elementary education social science exam or the middle school science exam, you would probably, you know, look through the practice test and the books and all of that, and you would kind of understand the content being assessed. You could memorize that content, and then when you're asked about it on the test, it's fairly simple to choose the correct answer. But with a reading assessment, you have to actually sharpen your reading skills. It's not as simple as just memorizing content. You're given a passage and you have to derive meaning or extract meaning from that passage and answer the questions correctly in a certain amount of time. So it's much different than a content-centered assessment. That's why I recommend that you strengthen your reading skills, because memorizing is not going to help you because you have no idea what test you're going to get on test day. So the skill has to be there. I like to equate reading to running. I'm a reading teacher, and I used to be a running coach, and I'm also an avid runner. And with running, you have to run little bits every day to get better. You can't just go out on a Saturday and run, you know, 8 miles and expect to get better. Not that it's not great to run 8 miles on a Saturday, but if you don't run at all and then all of a sudden you decide to go do a marathon, you're not going to make it very far, right? So you have to kind of work those skills over time in order to be strong enough for the marathon at the end. So think about your reading test as your marathon or half marathon, if you will, that you'll be running. And so we want to get up off that couch every day and do a little bit of reading. Now, I recommend 20 minutes per night. You do not have to do 3 hours or 4 hours a night, just 20 minutes of reading every night. Now, a couple of ways you can do this. You can go on Facebook and kind of like certain pages that release articles. So things like the New York Times, The Atlantic, Politico, or other publications that you might like. You're going to want to subscribe or like pages that have high Lexile levels. So a lot of publications are written at an eighth grade level because that's, you know, the easiest way for people to consume the information. But publications like the New York Times, The Economist, The Atlantic, they're all written at a higher Lexile, between a 10 and a 12 Lexile level. And so that will really help you in terms of, you know, getting that more complex vocabulary that you might see on test day. So I recommend that. And it's really hard, but you have to try not to scroll. Rather than scroll, read. We've become, you know, a society of scrollers, where we just kind of look for the link, click the link, it takes you someplace else, click that link, takes you someplace else. For this, you're going to want to, you know, slow down and do not scroll, read every line. Now, mark my word, when you do this, you will encounter vocabulary and concepts that you will see on your reading test. I promise you. There are so many times when I go in to take a practice reading test and I see some of the vocabulary I just read in an Economist article or in a New York Times article. They use that complex vocabulary you might see on the exam. Plus, it just makes you well-read, a better reader. It helps to strengthen that muscle, and it's a really great way just every day to read something, to learn something, and to get better at your reading. Now, beyond that, if you're really having trouble with, you know, reading a passage and answering the questions, you're going to want to locate reading passages with test questions attached to them. And there's a couple of ways to do that. Obviously, we have a lot in our books. You can also go get, you know, a bunch of prep books that have all different types of reading passages. You could go get an ACT book or an SAT book. You could get other Praxis Core study guides. You know, whatever you're practicing for, you could kind of, you know, get all the study guides you can. But that becomes kind of expensive. What I recommend you do is go on to the internet and grab some released ACT and released SAT tests. ACT has robust reading passages with complex problems similar to what you will see on your reading exam, and SAT has the same, and they have a lot of them. So you could essentially practice with one passage every night and still not run out of reading passages, all right? So let me show you what I mean when I talk about going and grabbing them off the internet. All right, so let's take a little jump over to my computer here, and you can see that I have Googled released ACT tests. Now you can see when I do that, a bunch of things pop up here. On Reddit, a lot of people will post their ACT tests, but they're kind of copyright protected. So I don't want to promote that. I want to promote only the right way to do it. And ACT and SAT, College Board, are nice enough to release past tests. And you can see here that we can find that. Now, if you scroll down a little bit, you'll see that here's a link right here for preparing for the ACT. And that is the official ACT. They release one every year. You can see this is 2020, 2021. In a few months, they will release 2021, 2022. And this is a full ACT. Now, they have everything here. I mean, this is like all the information about ACT. If you're just trying to get better at reading, what I recommend is you scroll through. You can see that section one is grammar. Section two is math. And section three, here it is right here, is always going to be reading. Now on the ACT, there are four reading passages and each reading passage has 10 questions. Now I recommend, let me zoom in here just for a second. I recommend keeping it online. Don't print it out because on test day, you have to do them online. Now, if you're studying for the ACT or SAT, you can print them out because ACT, SAT is done with paper, pencil. So you can do that. But if you're someone who's studying for the Praxis Core or another teacher certification exam that has to do with reading, I recommend keeping this online because that's something you have to do on test day. Now, the online portal for reading on these teacher certification exams is much different. It's, you know, got different buttons and things like that, but at least reading online here will help to kind of strengthen that digital reading muscle that you're gonna need on test day. Now, remember, I have a bunch of videos about reading and I have a free webinar for the Praxis Core reading. I also have some videos for the ACT reading and I'll link them up here, wherever that is. And you can go and look through those for the actual strategy. But remember, we always want to read our questions first. Always, always, always read our questions first. Now, if you're studying for the ACT, I have a very specific strategy for the ACT, especially when it comes to line numbers here, like they give you down here in number 10 and in number 8 here, you can see that there are line numbers here. So definitely watch that ACT reading video. That's going to help you. For those of you studying for your teacher certification exams, I recommend reading the questions first. Do not read the answer choices, okay? Don't read A, B, C, and D here, all right? Because there's three incorrect answers there and only one correct. So you don't want to fill your brain with a bunch of incorrect information. Just the question. You may also want to take your scratch paper and just jot down little pieces of the question on your scratch paper. That may slow you down. It all depends on how you, you know, do this. The more you practice this, the better you are going to be. For example, when I take a test like this, I use my scratch paper, jot down information about each question. Then I go in and read the passage and I essentially answer almost everything on my scratch paper where I never have to go back into the passage again. But I do this constantly. I'm making videos about it all the time. I'm, you know, always in analyzing tests and looking at them in different angles. So obviously I'm going to be a little bit better at this because my skill has been strengthened over time. You may not like writing down pieces of the question. You may just want to read the question first and then go in and read the passage. Now, one thing to remember, these passages are much longer than what you're going to see on the Praxis Core and other teacher certification exams. If you're studying for the ACT, it's going to look exactly like this. However, it doesn't hurt to read all kinds of different passages and answer all kinds of different questions because you don't know what you're going to get on test day. So it's okay that this is not identical to the Praxis Core. The skills assessed on the ACT and SAT are the same, and that is craft and structure, main idea, author's purpose, inference, also, you know, double passages relating one passage to the other. That's all here as well. All reading assessments assess the same thing. So it doesn't matter how long the passage is or how short, the skill is the same. And reading longer passages helps with your cognitive endurance. Remember I talked about running earlier? Well, just like endurance in running, we have to have cognitive endurance when it comes to reading. So reading longer passages and answering more questions actually helps with your cognitive endurance and will help you be better on test day. Now, the ACT always has four passages, and you can see here, here's passage one, here's passage two, here's passage three, and here's passage four. I like ACT because they have four different types of passage. They always have a literary passage. They always have a social science passage. Then they have a humanities passage. Then they have a natural science passage. So you kind of have a hodgepodge of, you know, literary text and informational text, which is similar to what you'll see on your teacher certification exams or other reading assessments, okay? So that's why I really like ACT. Now, a couple ways you can find more ACTs. Obviously, this is the one put out by ACT, but the top, when I Google released ACT tests, right now, this blog pops up as the top search for me, at least. When you do, this is a, this guy, he has a blog for helping people pass and get into college. I really like this guy's blog. We are not affiliated in any way, but I always send people here. He's got some really good information. And notice here, he has full-length ACT practice tests. And here they all are right here. So on top of that 2020, 2021, we have all of these practice tests here with answer choices or answer keys. So if you take a look, let's just go down here. This is 2011, 2012. This is what the ACT released back then. Still a great test, maybe old, but guess what? Let me go to section three, hang on. We still have really good passages here with really good questions. So if you're looking to do, you know, a passage a night, this is a great place to be here because this has four passages, this has four passages, each one has four passages. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tests here, all with four passages. That's 24 days right there because I recommend doing one passage a day. Now, beyond just reading and answering the questions and going, oh, I got a 70 and moving on, I recommend you analyze why you got something right and why you got something wrong. That's when you're going to get better. So not only are you going to read the questions first, read the passage, answer the questions, that's the strategy, right? Once you check your answers, figure out, why did I miss this? What did I go for? Oh, I thought it was C, and look, there's a trap there in C. I wasn't paying attention. Or, oh, you know what? I forgot about this in line 60 here. Really get in there and analyze why you got something wrong. Do to yourself what you would do to your students, which is do like a miscue analysis here or a accuracy analysis. Why? And really look at why you got something correct as well. So you can do that again when it's time to take the test. So really important to analyze your answers, both correct and incorrect. Okay, do that. Now, beyond ACT, you can also Google released SAT tests. Now, SAT has it on their website really nicely laid out. So College Board is the company that makes SAT, and you can see here, this is the collegeboard.org website. And you can see that if I scroll down on this page, here are all the SAT tests, okay? Now, we have other sections there. So if we want to see all, we can see practice test one, then essay, answers, and all of that. Let's just go to download all five here. When I do, it comes in a zip folder, and you can see that here they are right here. So we have a practice sheet, all of that, and then we have the practice test. Now, here is the practice test, and you can see that it's 64 pages here. Now, reading for the ACE or for the SAT is always section one. And you can see it's set up very similar as the ACT. We have the passage here, and then we have the questions. Now in this case, again, I recommend reading the questions first and then going in and reading the passage. Use your note paper to jot down important information and keep this online. Now, SAT has something a little bit different than ACT in that SAT has some embedded charts and graphs and things like that, which is very similar to what the Praxis Core has. The Praxis Core has charts and graphs often in their reading assessment. So I definitely recommend taking a look at this this assessment here for SAT. Now, the good thing about SAT is that they have answer explanations. And I love answer explanations because it helps you understand why you have the correct answer versus incorrect answer. So you're definitely going to want to take a look at these practice test answer explanations here because that will really help you. So right here is the practice test. You can see it's all right here, and here's section one for reading. And then you have the answer explanations here, which helps you to understand why you got something correct and why you got something incorrect. Definitely take a look at the answer explanations, analyze those answers, and make sure you're good to go for test day. Now, beyond that, both the ACT and SAT have practice grammar and math. So I recommend doing that as well. Now, the math on the SAT is a little bit harder than the math on the ACT. I like the math on the ACT better because it's multiple choice and I don't have to fill in anything. SAT is a little bit more challenging. So if you're going to practice math, I would do that on ACT. I would say the first 40 problems on the ACT are similar to what you'll see on a teacher certification exam like the Praxis Core. Anything above 40 tends to be a little bit more complicated than what you'll see on the Praxis Core. So 1 through 40, 1 through 30 is what I would use to practice that. Now, for the grammar, definitely check out the grammar sections of both ACT and SAT. If you're someone who struggles with grammar, this is a great place to get more information, more practice, so that you can be prepared on test day. Again, we have an amazing book, New Praxis Core, second edition, that is awesome, but some of you really like practice tests, like you wanna work through those practice tests. And if you already do all of the ones that we have in our book, you're gonna need more practice. So this is a great place to get that. All right, so hopefully that helps you identify and locate more practice if you're working towards your Praxis Core reading or other certification exam. Of course, if you're looking to do better on the ACT or SAT, this is definitely where you need to go, release tests and practice those skills. And remember, reading is a skill that needs to be practiced. If you don't read for a few weeks, notice when you try to read aloud, it's very choppy. You stumble over words. But if you've been reading every day, you know, 20 minutes a day, you're flying through that those reading passages and that information accurately and quickly. So that's really important. Just like running, you got to get off the couch and work on that endurance. The same goes for reading. You've got to get up, stop scrolling, read, and work on that cognitive endurance so that you can do better on your standardized reading tests. Thank you so much for watching today. I'm going to link up everything in the description so you have the links to go to what you need in order to access this information online. We appreciate you watching our YouTube channel. Please consider subscribing and letting your friends and colleagues know we're here. And also hit that notifications button so you're notified when we upload new content. Have an awesome day.